How do you teach Java DC and this video we want to learn the materials in Revit. This is the 19th session of Revit architecture course that we have for free. Make sure to check the playlist for other episodes. Let's learn the materials. Before doing anything, you need to know the difference between library, material and asset. Library is the set of materials that we have. For example, in materials we have concrete, we have wood flooring and those kind of things. And we have assets which we use for appearance. For example, we have different concrete with different physical information and identity, but their look is same as each other. So to prevent from doing this manually every time, we create a concrete asset and we use that concrete appearance asset for each concrete material that we have, and their appearance are linked together, but their identity and their physical data are different. Now you know the difference between library, asset and material, let's create some materials for ourselves. To access, to manage materials, you need to go to the manage tab, and in the settings panel, go to the material window, and in here you can see all of the materials that you have. You can use the ready to use assets of Revit, I will talk about them later, and also if you have another or local library, you can see it in here. Let's create a new material. Click on this one and let's create a new material. Let's call it maybe TAT or TOT and test one. I will put the TAT abbreviation, or you can put your own abbreviation, because when I want to find my own material, I can search for TAT and I will see all of the materials that I've made in this project. And then we have identity tab, which will allow you to bring information in your materials, for example keywords, class of it, comments, and also you can tag your materials according to these options in here. So this is really important option in information part. Also then we have graphic part that will specify the way that we want to see our materials in different views. For example, the first option that we have in here is shading, which will specify the way that you will see your element in shading. For example, let's place the color of it on maybe light yellow, and also I don't want any transparency. Let's click on OK and let's assign that material to this roof that we have in here. Let's go to the edit structure and let's search for TAT in here, and let's click on OK and OK. Now can see when we are in shading mode, we can see this material in yellow. Let's go to the edit type of it and let's modify our material from here. And then we have surface pattern and cut pattern. Surface pattern is where your material are not cutted, and cut pattern, as the name describes, are the patterns that you want to see when your materials in a cut situation. For example, let's put the foreground on a straight line that we have in here. Also, we have drafting and model. Hatches drafting. Hatches will change their scale according to your scale, but the model will still remain. For example, let's put it on something. Let's go to the model and let's put it on something like this. And let's go to the modify of it and let's put it on a bigger number, maybe 100 millimeter. Click on OK and OK. Let's put the color of it on black. Let's go and see the results. And now you can see it is horizontal, so you need to rotate it. Let's put it on 0. Click on OK. And now you can see this part in here. And let's bring back our section box because it is hidden. And now let's isolate our roof and our section box. First of all, let's put this roof in a section box. I want to describe the section patterns for you. Let's isolate them and let's bring the section box in. And now you can see all of the layers of this roof. I want to assign a color to this section part of this layer. To do that, you need to edit type or edit the material of it, and you need to assign a cut pattern. For example, let's go to the foreground and let's assign this one to our cut pattern for this material. Click on OK and Okay, now you can see it in here. If it's not it's not showing the exact thing to you because you need to change the scale of it, because this is a little bit big for this scale, so you can change the scale of it really easily from this part, or let's put it on solid fill and let's assign a color to see it in action. So now I can have a solid fill or solid pattern for my cut parts of this material, and that's the way that we can manage our patterns for our materials. To be able to create materials, you need to understand the different maps that we have. We have a diffuse or albedo map, and then we have a bump or normal or displacement map that gives our material a depth and its texture, and then we have some reflection maps, we have roughness maps, and each of them has their own usage. For example, with reflection, we specify the amount of reflection or which parts have more reflection in our material, and we have the same thing with roughness, and also we have cutouts which will cut some of the parts of the material that we choose, and other kind of maps that I will explain them in material editor. Now you know the difference between different maps. To get familiar with materials, I want to create two materials for the concrete blocks and also wood flooring. To do that, you need to go to the, for example, let's select this wall. I want to assign our concrete blocks to this one. Let's go to the edit type of it, and let's go to the edit structure, and let's select the concrete layer that we have in here, and let's create a new material for it. Let's rename it to, let's create a new one, and let's rename it to tot-secon-blocks, and I don't care about the graphics parts of it right now. Let's go to the appearance of it, and now I have three maps for my concrete blocks that I have in here. This is the bomb map, this is the diffuse map or the base map, and also this is the specular map or reflection map. To bring your textures in, the easiest way is to drag it. For example, just drag your textures and release it in here, and I don't want any glossiness for this one, maybe about 5, and I want a really low number of reflectivity. For example, let's put it on 2, and then I don't want this material to be transparent, or I don't want to cut out anything. I don't want our concrete to shine, so I will put these three unchecked. But I want a bomb map, just check it, and then just drag your bomb map to here. But let's see the preview of our material on our wall, and we will change all of the things later. To see the preview of your material, you need to render it, or you can place your visual style on realistic, and you can see a preview of it. Or if you are using Inkscape, you can see it in Inkscape too. You can see we have the blocks, but it is really small, so we need to change the scale of it. So let's make it bigger. For example, let's go to the base map, and in here, let's change the, when they are linked, it will change the width and height proportionally. For example, let's put it on about 4,500 millimeter. Click on done and apply. You can see it is okay, but again, we see some smaller blocks in here, because when you are changing the base map scale, you need to change the scale of your bombs too. So in here, make sure to go to the base map and turn on the link texture, because it will link the bomb map and textures from now on. And let's check the link in here, link the texture in here, and let's put it on 4,500 millimeter. Click on done and okay, and now you can see your texture with more depth in here, because we have assigned our bump better. And let's see it in Inkscape too, to see it in action. You can see the material in here, and can see the depths that we have with bomb map. You don't need to know the Inkscape. I will talk about the native render engine of Revit in future sessions. Don't worry about it. I just wanted to show you the material in here, and you can get much better materials with a little bit more time to put on this material. and let's create the wood floor for here too. For example, let's select this one and let's go to the edit type. And let's create a wood flooring for ourselves. Let's rename it and let's put it on TAT wood. And I have three maps for my wood in here. You can see I have a bomb map and I have a base map, and I also have a specular or reflectivity map or reflection map. For example, let's bring the main map and we need to make it bigger too. For example, let's go to the map and make sure to link the texture. And also in a scale part, I want it about 5,000. Click on done. And now for our wood flooring, we want a little bit higher number of glossiness, or maybe a low number. I want more reflectivity, not the glossiness. And in reflectivity part, let's put it on a bigger number, maybe let's check 50, and then we can change it later. And also in bomb map, let's bring on bomb map in here to have a little bit depth, and I want to put it on a lower number, maybe 20, and let's scale it to, let's put it on 5,000. Click on done, and now let's set in action. You can see we have our flooring in here. It will be much better if you would put more time in here. As I said, this is a beginner course, guys. I will have more videos about rendering and realistic renderings in my Inkscape for Revit playlist. You can check there too. And also we have too many videos for material creation and for in each specific material in our channel. And that was the wood flooring. And now let's learn about the other things that we have in materials. Maybe you want to analyze your design for energy analysis or a structural analysis. That's the time you need to have the physical or thermal information of your material. You can go to the material editor and add the new tab for it, and you can assign your thermal and physical information and you can use them in your analysis. Before diving into the next tool that we want to learn, make sure to like this video and share it with your friends to help YouTube reach this video to more people. Boss, I'm really bored. I can't create all of these materials. This is really time consuming.
But you can use ready-to-use materials, my friend. You don't need to create all of them.
As Boss said, we don't need to create all of the materials by ourselves. We can create our materials, but we can use ready-to-use assets of Revit. For example, I've created let's create a generic material for ourselves and let's rename it to test 3. And now I don't want to create my flooring, and I want to use ready to use assets. To do that, click on this part, and now you can see the ready to use assets and material assets of Revit. Let's put it on thumbnail and let's put it on 256. And now go to the appearance library, and you have different categories. For example, let's go to the flooring. Now we have different floorings in here. For example, let's bring these floors, this flooring in here, and click on this option in here. And now you can see your asset in here, and the settings for the ready-to-use assets is different according to the material that you've selected. For example, we don't have bump in here. We have relief pattern and those kind of options. And the customization is a little bit lower, but it will save your time. For example, let's click on OK. And now, let's assign it to here and let's see it in action. You can see it is not bad at all, because we didn't spend any time, and you can change it and make sure to explore other categories. There are many good materials in there. There are some ugly materials, but there are good materials too, and you can use them in your works and you can save your time there. Sometimes for any reason, like maybe you are in a schematic design phase and you don't want to have the layers of each wall and floor and you just want to see the finishing, or sometimes you have some material that doesn't have a big thickness and you don't want to make them as a layer, but you want to see them as a finished material of some surfaces, that's when paint comes in and you can use paint very easily to assign materials to them. To access paint, you need to go to the modify tab And in here we have our paint option in this part, and also you have on paint too, or you can press PT on your keyboard and then you will have this window and you can paint materials to different places. For example, let's put this flooring in here. Let's bring the flooring. And now you can see it is really easy to assign our materials to each face that we want. But as I said, this is great for schematic faces and they don't have any thickness. And if you want to unpaint somewhere, you can click on unpaint also, and you can select that face. And let's go to the landscape and you can see they are working exactly like that we had those materials with edit type. And make sure to check other episodes for our Revit free course to learn other parts of Revit. And also, if you are familiar with Revit, make sure to share this course with your friends and they can learn Revit from zero.